is called as va. So the light is a wave and a particle. Particle is va. The energy is ra. As such, whenever you want to do any transition in the Puranas, you say vara. Va plus ra is vara. So Paramatma operated the physical body, one with light, that is as the basic energy. For a transition, he operated with the mind. And these energies are to be carried by a carrier. The carrier of energy in the world is vayu, that is the air. The air carries all forms of energy, whether it is the light or the energy of the mind. Everything has to operate only through air as the medium. So vayu is the link. And vayu is the one, is the transporter, it is the vehicle for the Paramatma to operate the body. And also for the body to meet the Paramatma, vayu is needed. The vayu carries the agni also, that is the prana. So the vayu carries the mind, vayu carries the agni. The agni is called as prana, the mind is called as yama. As such, if you want to meet the Paramatma, you have to take the vayu. Then take the prana and the yama together and meet the Paramatma. That is why it is called as pranayama in yoga. So vayu is a very essential factor. So we can say the Paramatma operates through a vehicle called as vayu. He uses a material, an alterable material called as the mind. The energy that is used is the ray of light. These are the three things that is necessary in this world. The vayu, which is in motion, is represented by the letter called as dha. The ray of light is represented by ra. The mind is represented by ma. So how the universe is built? It is dha plus ra plus ma. So the function of the universe is what is called as dha plus ra plus ma. It is called dharma. In the dharma, in Kannada if you say, for that matter, we have got what is called as a supporting letter, ottakshara. Ra is written at the top, ma is written at the bottom. That is how it is to be written. Unfortunately, they write this ardhakshara of the man forward. That is not the manner in which the things are to be written. When you say mantra, you have to write ma, then you have to write na. Below that you have to put ta, below that you have to put the ra. This is the way the expression is to be done. But due to the influence of the Sanskrit, we have made so many changes in the Kannada also, which is not correct scientifically. As such, dharma means flowing air is represented by da, ray of light is represented by ra, and mohita manas. What does it indicate? The ray of light is to be increased such that it can move the Paramatma, because Paramatma operated through the ray of light. If you want to meet the Paramatma, the light's energy must be increased and taken to a higher level. Who has to take it? It is the mind. As such, the mind comes below, ra comes above, indicating that ra is lifted by the ma, that is the supporting letter. So the purpose of life is the ray of light called as pranavapana vyanavadana samana satprana, that is svetavarna, is to be lifted by the mind. This is the purpose of the life. So dharma means lifting the energy of the soul to the Paramatma, that is ra, with the help of the mind called as ma. And the carrier of this energy is what is called as dha. So dha means the flow of air you are going to use. Ma means you are going to use the mind. You lift up the energy of the soul and move toward the Paramatma. So dharma is you have started your journey from the Paramatma, and moving back and meeting the Paramatma is what is called as dha. So from this you can see the man is increasing the quantum of energy because the mind is associated with it. Since the mind is associated with it, wherever the mind is, that is the quantum of energy of the human. When he is with the Jivatma, lifts up the energy, he gets the strength as strong as the sun, because the sun's replica is Jivatma. When he moves further and beyond, he goes at velocities far exceeding the velocity of light, such that he can defeat the concept of time. Consequently, the Trikalagnana comes when once he is in between the Swadhisthana and the Sahasra. Well, when the Trikalagnana comes, you are aware of what happens yesterday, what happens today, what happens tomorrow, and you will get the knowledge of for all times to come. If you get the knowledge, whomsoever, whatever the process through which you get the knowledge is called Guru. This particular state is called as Paramatma, is called as Para, the Atman is called as Brahma, this passage is called as Parabrahma, and in the Parabrahma state, you are crossing the barriers of velocity of light, and that state is what is called as Guru. So, Parabrahma, Dvijihi or Parabrahma Guru, that Parabrahma Vyavastha we are trying to do. So, Dharma is basically, it will increase the quantum of energy of the man to the level of the Paramatma. At the time of the creation, the man was extremely knowledgeable. All the human had a Trikalagna. But Paramatma gave an option, whether to be with the Paramatma, that is to be with the ascending energy, or to come down and to be with the descending energy. People felt that body's comfort is much more, and this is very, very difficult to do it. Consequently, they went on losing the energy. So at the time of creation, everyone was a child of the Paramatma. Everyone had the capacity of the Paramatma himself. Whatever the capacity of the Paramatma, every human possessed across the earth. As such, there was no Taratamya at the time of the creation. Everyone was a Brahmana. It means he had a Brahma Jnana at that time. And there was no other Varnashrama at all, Varna at all at the time of the creation. Afterwards, what happens? The man descended down. Then he went into different levels of energy. Different levels of human came into existence because the strength of the soul got reduced. So the purpose of Dharma is to take back the energy to the Paramatma and become the Paramatma yourself. Once you become the Paramatma, you enjoy the status of the Paramatma. What is the status of the Paramatma? Paramatma operates at infinite velocity, you will also operate at infinite velocity. When the velocity becomes infinite, the matter is almost, there is no state of matter at all. M tends to become zero. E equals mc square. So when M tends to become zero, you are in a state, no state of matter at all. That state is what is called as moksha. That is why the Shastra says not moksha, it says moksha naam. Na means agni, convert the agni of the body into the energy of the Paramatma. That is the reason of the moksha naam, the word comes, not moksha. So when once you get into that state, there is no, you are not going to take birth again and again, there the function closes. So the rebirth will not occur only when you become the Paramatma. Till such time, you are going to take birth again and again and again. So the purpose of life is to increase your quantum of energy such that you are more stronger, you are more mighty, you are more knowledgeable, life after life. For that we have to add the energy to the soul and move further upwards. Whatever the material you have used in your construction, if everything is strong, then only you can become the Paramatma. So when once I took birth, I took the help of the Panchabhutas. I took the help of, subsequently, I took the help of my father and the mother. I took the help of the Jnanis who are there in this world. Then I took the help of the Atman. So all these energies I have taken the help. So it means I am using those materials also. If I don't pay back the energy which I have used, then you are under debt. Again you will not go to the moksha. As such, it is the duty of every person to increase the strength of the Panchabhutas. If there is methods and methodologies. It is the duty of every person to protect the knowledgeable people, because the knowledgeable people are basically the strength of the society. They must be considered as the property of the society. As such, these knowledgeable people who have got an inner knowledge is what is called as Rishi. Rishi is one who can rush internally is what is called as Rishi. So Rishi must be taken as the property of the material, property of the society. And those people must be called to the house, ask them how to carry on the penance, how to get the knowledge of the whole universe, get the knowledge of the Vedas. And this is called as Rishi Yajna, or it is also called as Atithi Yajna. Increasing the strength of the nature is called as Daiva Yajna. So it means two Yajnas are to be done. Yajna means quantifying the energy through Pancha Prana is what is called as Yajna. You add energy, anything if you add energy, it is called Yajna. If you add energy to the Brahman called Atman, then it is called as Brahma Yajna. To enunciate it, what we do is Brahmopadesha, we do it. To go near that and be always around it and enter the soul, that is called as Brahmopadesha or Upanayana. So it means in Brahma Yajna, you are increasing the quantum of energy of the soul. In Daiva Yajna, you are increasing the quantum of energy of the Prakriti. Then Rishi Yajna, you are respecting the Jnanis. And you are taking the use of the Jnanis for the benefit of the